Hello and welcome to Kimber Bushcrafts. And as you saw today, I put up a banner, a raven banner. And I think that's suit this camp very nicely. I love the old fashioned there. Beside that, I have something I would show you and talk about. And it's also today I have my shout out of the month. So hang on.
Yeah, and look at this. Isn't it also cool? It's from Grimfrost. Also the banner, and I put linked in my on my website, so you can find them if you want. You can say I'm in my raven period. Now my beard is so long that I can put something in it, and I think this is cool.
And the symbol of the raven is the symbol of Odin, the old godfather. He had two ravens on his throne, his chair, and they were called Hugin and Munin. And they flew out in the world and came back to Odin with information of what happened around in his kingdom and of course in all over the world. So the raven is a symbol for Odin and many warlords during the Viking Age used that banner. There's examples from different kind of drawings from that time that tells that this kind of banner was used. They don't know if it's only a war symbol or it's a symbol for a particular warlord. But nevertheless, I bought this from Grimfrost and put it up, and I think it's really cool. I love it very much. Some time ago I was tagged by one of my good YouTube friends, Wade from Woodwalkers 1965, and he tagged me in a thing called Show Me Your Three Luxury Items. And today I'm going to tell you my three luxury items and tell you why I have bought that, or I have that. I know I'm going to tag some other people. I will only tag one, I'll tell you that who that is later. But now I would like to present the items that I've chosen to represent my luxury items and the reason why I do that. So hang on. Yeah, and these three items I consider to be luxury for me. We'll take this one first. Geert's lantern in brass, and it costs about three times as much as one in plain metal. So for me that's luxury when you have when you can afford to buy something that expensive that only have the same properties as the other ones. You all know I love brass, and I think this is a cool addition to my camp, my old school theme, and I just love it when I'm out here in my camp doing an overnighter, and I can bring this along with me together with my Petromax and light it up. For me it's given me a nice feeling when I know that it's quality, and I know that this is for me old school. The other thing is also in brass, and it is the Svea stove. And I'll call this a luxury because you don't need a stove like this. This is a stove you can use everywhere, but you can buy stoves that are as good as this one, but for a quarter of the price. This one is very expensive too, and when you choose to buy this item, such an item that is so expensive, I think it's luxury. And I use some of my YouTube money for this. If I didn't have YouTube, I wouldn't afford to buy stuff like this so expensive. So for me this is old school, and it's very expensive and luxury. I'm going to make my fire today on this stove because the weather has turned out very badly. It's raining and blowing, and well, it's a little bit cold out here, so I don't want to make my fire outside. I'll use this one. And the last item is this pouch. It's not only the pouch, This pouch is very expensive, and I got it from Lemel Coffee. They offered me this. It's made of elk skin, and it's very soft, and it is made actually for their coffee. So I love it very much, and also very old school. But it's not only the coffee pouch, but also the coffee inside. Lemel Coffee is an expensive coffee, but for me it is worth all the money. It tastes great, and it has a good aroma. And this is whiskey coffee, which I love, but ordinary Lemel Coffee is also very nice and tastes delicious. It is made especially for cooking coffee, Sami coffee or Cowboy coffee, and that's why it's a little bit expensive. For me, it's luxury to have the opportunity to use and taste good quality coffee that is made especially for that type of coffee that I'm making. So, luxury for me to be able to buy these Lemel Coffee and also the pouch that I got from them. So this is my three items. So thank you, Wade, for tagging me on this subject. I think it was an interesting subject to talk about, and I hope you also find my choice of luxury items interesting. I know a lot of you people don't have the money to buy these things. I understand that, but now when I'm in a position where I get a little bit money from YouTube and also my very wonderful Patreons, I can afford to buy stuff that I think is worth the money. So I'm very grateful for that. But even though you don't have money for luxury items, you have the same pleasure of going out in the forest, in the nature, enjoy it, and cook your food or your water for coffee on even the cheapest little stove. And if you have a very cheap lantern with you and some ordinary coffee, that is cool too. That doesn't matter. I'm sure you will enjoy it. And I'm going to tag Shane from Isle of Wight Bushcraft. He has a great channel, and I hope you will take this challenge to you, Shane, and show me your three luxury items. I'm sure you have a good reason for using those, and I'm very excited to hear that. And now this month's shout out. It is for Justin Barber in Canada, Newfoundland, and Labrador. He's making a lot of trips there with his canoe and his dog, and I follow him on every one of his adventures, and I can recommend you to do the same. He makes some very great videos his way for several weeks on some of his adventures, and he show you how the landscape is down in Labrador and Newfoundland. It's a really cool place. I love to watch his videos. It's very relaxing, and well, he makes a lot of stuff. He also have sometimes he having trouble with his canoe when he's sailing down some very wild rivers, and there's a little action in that too. And the tranquility in his camp at night is so great to follow him. So Justin Barber, I put a link below so you can see it, and I hope you like that. Nice coffee, whiskey coffee with whiskey in. Doesn't get better than that. Well, folks, this is all for now. I hope you enjoyed this little video. I think it's gonna be a short video, but in 14 days I'm planning to make a trip with my good friend Johnny to a place called Klosterheden down in Jutland. I think it's kind of a national park. At least it's a very cool place, Johnny has told me. There are beavers down there, and we're going to make an overnight there. I'm looking very much forward to that. To see Johnny again, but also to come in a new place and discover that. And beside that, I have a little wonderful thing that I would like to tell you. Yeah, and the thing is, I bought a canoe. Just a small one that I can sail in, perhaps together with another person. My wife, hopefully. She's very fond of canoe trips. But it's a way to try to make some videos that is a little bit different from the one I'm making now. There's not a lot of rivers or creeks that I can sail in here in Denmark. We have a few here in my place in North Jutland, but I think it's going to be day trips or perhaps with an overnighter. I don't know. And my hope is that I can come back to Sweden and make a trip over there, perhaps with another person, perhaps Johnny. I know he's having a kayak, and perhaps we could make a trip there too. But if the border is open here during the summer, my wife and I has planned to make a trip to Norway again, and I would like to bring my canoe with me there too. So I'm looking very much forward to sailing a canoe and owning my own, so I can do it whenever I want. So I hope you enjoy these little videos and the video that is coming here in a couple of weeks. So now I'm going home, edit my video and launch it sometime this weekend. Hope you enjoy. Thank you again for watching Kimmo Bushcraft. I really appreciate that. And for all your support and all your kindness. Thank you very much. Hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye and take care.